What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Showcycle back with another video. Today, you know, we're talking about a topic that's pretty close to home. Now, imagine this, right? Imagine you had a game and you had a franchise. The game was off of a beloved franchise. And, you know, they had a game that they made a while back that was amazing. And then they, you know, decided to change it from the formula without, you know, really giving us a lot of depth into the formula. And, they ended up making Sonic Forces. Yeah. So, I can judging by the thumbnail, judging by the title of this video, we'll probably have, you'll probably already know what game I'm talking about. Now, today we're going to be talking about Sonic Riders and, you know, the possible sequel to the game franchise. Now, we're not going to talk about how bad Sonic Forces was. If you're a Sonic fan, or even if you're not a Sonic fan, you played a couple Sonic games. If you play Sonic Forces, you know how Sonic Forces is. So we don't have to discuss that. Maybe for another video. Other than that, though, let's talk about Sonic Riders. Now, this game is a game very near and dear to my heart. And don't get me wrong, this game is not without its problems. And you know, I'm probably just looking at it with biased glasses. Just the simple fact that I've played it when I was younger, and you know, the fact that I'm reminiscing on it now, you know, it might be a better game in my mind than it is to you guys. But I love Sonic Riders. I love the whole concept of it. It made so much sense because Sonic, I feel like Sonic was always meant to be a racing game. It was always meant to be a racing game. And the way they did it was, you know, there are some characters in the actual franchise of Sonic that are just not as fast as Sonic. You know, you have Shadow, you have the silver guy. You know, they're just not as fast as Sonic, but you know, they make them use vehicles in this game, and we're not really gonna get into the whole, you know, biological who's the fastest in Sonic debate. Trust me, I've had that debate. It doesn't sound like a smart debate, and it is not. I've had that debate. I'm gonna go and move on from that. Just talking about the game in general. Yes, I really did enjoy Sonic Riders. I felt like it was, when it came onto the scene, it was a breath of fresh air. You know. And then the second one dropped, and I feel like the second one is the one that people played the most. Because that was the one that was out. And, you know, it just felt like it was out. I don't even remember the original Sonic Riders. I think it was on PlayStation, I want to say. I can't even remember, but I remember playing 2 very well. I remember doing a lot in 2, trying to unlock all the vehicles and such. And I think the games really don't have that no more. And I talked about My Hero 1 Justice in another video not too long ago, and I think I talked about it was One Punch Man. Talking about the only redeemable quality in Punch Man was that fact that you felt like you had to earn this stuff, you know. They didn't just give you all the, you know, I wanna be hero toolkit, you know what I'm saying? They didn't just give it all to you. You had to go grind out your abilities. So I kinda get it, you know, I kinda enjoyed it. I felt like that part, that aspect of the gameplay made a lot more sense. And that was how Sonic Riders 2 was. You know, you out there, you go, and you do races, you get money to buy the newer equipment. And it always felt like it refreshed, because it always felt like you had something to do. So, I gotta say, I mean, looking at some of the newer Sonic games now, I am quite disappointed, because I feel like Sonic as a whole is going into a direction that we just don't want to go into at the moment. So, other than that, now, what would the Sonic Riders 3 be about? Of course, you know, the Sonic mythos, as you could say, isn't really too deep, but there's a lot of depth they can go into. They can use to somehow find a way to, you know, revive this series. I mean, I liked it, Silva as a character. I mean, we got the Mario and Sonic Olympics that just came out not so long ago, and that was okay from what I heard. You know, I think it did okay, you know, but I mean, I never understand this. Like, you're a developer, you're a game company, you're a franchise or whatever, and you have all these great games in your backlog, like all these amazing games, and you decide not to build off them. I get the need to try something different. You know, you always want to try something different. Like, if we got past a, you know, another version of Sonic Riders, we got past like 4 or 5 Sonic Riders, I would say, yeah, it's time to stop. Yeah, it's definitely time to stop. I get that. You know, try to evolve, try to make newer things. Because honestly, I mean, that's how we get games that grow. You know, that's how we get games that actually mean something and actually do something later. Let me know in the comments down below if you guys would like to see a sequel to Sonic Riders. And what system would you like it on? Other than that, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next video.